So we've got the pleasure of having Samantha McLean here, founder of Elite Agent Magazine, and it's such a resource, this magazine. If you don't get a copy, make sure you go and grab one. Mm. Go to your Elite Agent Magazine website as well. But Samantha, can I just ask you a question? When did Elite Agent Magazine, when was it born?
Oh.
When did it start?
Actually, funnily enough, at ARIC 3 years ago.
Really?
ARIC 2014, yeah. I was sitting in the audience actually taking notes for John that day and got a bit enthusiastic.
John McGrath. Yep.
And as people do, and I sort of thought, well, I miss having an industry magazine, I'm going to start my own. Yeah. So I tweeted something to that effect and then I had to hold myself to it. So, as we're talking about in the last one, all the musts became musts.
It's become a process.
Had a deadline between May the 27th and September 2014, and I met it, actually.
Wow, there you are. And three years later, here we are. Amazing. What a top publication. It's a real pleasure that we get to get this sort of resource out there. So, Samantha, in this issue, I wanted to talk a little bit about leadership.
Yep.
Because it's a topic out there, and there's a lot of change in the marketplace. You know, if you look at the last 6 to 12 months now, new agencies popping up, agents being offered ridiculous commissions, different models being brought up, super teams being, starting within offices, etc. Yeah. In this issue of, about leadership, what could you tell us about the state of play with leadership at the moment?
Yeah, well, there's a survey that's been done by CoreLogic, and it does show varying different states of leadership in the industry. So some of it's good, some of it's not so good. Mm. Sometimes as you might think, unless you actually ask people how you're doing as a leader, sometimes your perception of how you're doing as a leader might be different to how you're actually doing. There is a growing need, I think, in the real estate industry for leadership to step up, whether that's more education or greater interaction with staff or being more inclusive, because as you say, we dealt with a lot of leadership topics in this issue, teams being one of them, and I do believe that teams is going to be a massive trend.
And I think we're seeing that trend right now.
Yeah.
Especially the last 6 to 12 months, me being in the trenches with a lot of agents, I'm seeing agents having like a team of 4 to 5 people, mm-hmm. from a buy specialist, lead generation, admin. Like, you're just seeing all these specialty bits of the industry changing.
Yeah.
And what does that mean for someone like, for example, an agent who could just be a one-man agent versus, going up someone in their core area that's got a team of 5?
Yeah, I think obviously look out, because the team of 5, they're going to be spreading themselves, high and wide, because, and in non-traditional roles too, I think. You might have someone who's managing your social media, you might have someone who's managing your content marketing, you might have someone that's actually, and then you've got your traditional roles
of obviously,
videographers
and
so on. that are just non-traditional, but still an integral part of the team. I mean, lots of teams that I'm seeing too have got what they call a Donna, as in Harvey's Donna in suits, someone that just knows what they want before they want. And I guess that's what, that's what we talk about when we say super teams.
Yes.
Is that, there's definite people on definite bases, they know their roles and they work together like clockwork.
Yeah, they all know exactly what their role. And I think, just coming on the back of ARIC, and we saw a lot of superstar agents, rock stars that have these super teams, and everyone knew their role, knew their KPIs, what their job role is, know?
Well, I think that's half the battle in leadership, really, is that, if someone doesn't know what they're supposed to be doing, and I guess that, that came through a little bit in the survey as well, you really have to know what you're doing and how it is that you're going to get there.
Yeah.
So clear KPIs and clear measurement against those KPIs, and there's a couple of articles in there about good measurement of teams as well. So if anyone's sort of a bit iffy about, how do I set KPIs and how do I get the most out of my team? There's some stuff in there on that as well.
Well, beautiful. Did you see the Gary Vaynerchuk and Tom Panos video at ARIC, where Gary Vaynerchuk actually talks about leadership, and he said, "You see all those people out there? I work for them."
Yeah.
And I just thought the different way, they don't work for me, I work for them. So it's just having that change that I'm working for them. I'm, working for those people out in the marketplace. It's just a different way to look at things as a leader, you know? And I think the psychology and the mindset around leadership is
different.
Is different today.
Well, it's funny, you know, Josh Beacon came into our office a couple of weeks and said to, you know, our marketing assistant, Chantel, who's lovely, Shan, if you're watching this.
Yeah, of course you are.
You know, like he said, so Chantel, are those two doing a good job for you?
Wow.
Like, you know, referring to Mark and I, and it's, you know, like, I think it's true, you know, you've sort of got to, you know, it's not just being of service to your customers now, and obviously our readers are my boss.
Yeah.
Like, you know, like I need to put things in the magazine that people
relevant.
Actually want to read to keep everybody happy. And so, you know, like I think that's true too, is like a lot of people do see themselves as being more inclusive than, you know, than they maybe are. And I think more and more and more, you know, you talk about a why in coaching, and I think people want more of a reason to work for the companies that they do work for.
Oh, yeah.
So, you know, like, it's like, what purpose does this company have beyond making a dollar?
Yeah.
Like, you know, so there's a lot of that sort of thinking going on that we're sort of seeing as well.
That's right. It's not about the dollar, right? It's about the vision of the leader. Where does he want to take it to?
Yeah, about how do I feel about working for this company, like, you know, like, how does it make me feel at the end of the day, which is like, which is a big thing, particularly for, you know, like, younger employees and stuff like that. So if you want to attract them, there's got to be some higher purpose than just
absolutely
making a dollar.
And if I can remember for myself as an agent, my first mentor was a gentleman by the name of John Gordon, who was principal of LG Hooker Bondi Junction.
Yep.
We had a one-on-one on a Friday at 9 o'clock. Oh, you could not wait till 9 o'clock on a Friday to meet with him, because he was more of a mentor. And yes, we went through KPIs and numbers, but at the end of the day, he was more interested in me and where I was going with my life, rather than so much going, okay, how many calls have you made and everything else. That was important, don't get me wrong, but it was more about me and, you know, what was happening in my life. And I thought that's exactly, it's all about the feeling and how you feel at the end of each day when you work for that company.
Yeah, absolutely.
So,
yeah, like, just like your customers.
Absolutely.
Yep.
Oh, cool. Okay, so Sam, this is the latest issue of
Elite
Agent Magazine with our favourite lady here, Leanne from Mighty Mackay, who's taking out this year's Transform. Are we going to have Transform 2018?
Oh.
Have we made a decision yet?
Well,
or should we speak to Mark?
No, we should speak to Mark. Well, we're sort of working out what to do for the next 6 months. So we did a PM Transform last year. And we may be doing something similar but slightly different, but I can't quite reveal what that's going to be.
Stay tuned.
So stay tuned.
Or jump on the Elite Agent Magazine website or follow them on their social media
platforms.
That's
right. You got to follow along for announcements leading up to AFM. Yeah.
Fantastic. Hey Sam, thanks for popping in today. We really enjoyed hearing your story of how Elite Agent Magazine was actually born, and also thanks so much for giving so much to the industry. I know a lot of the guys that watch this will take a lot and benefit heaps.
Well, thank you. I hope they do, and thanks very much for having me.
Thanks, Sam. High five.
High five.